We return now to the president's proposal to limit the NSA's ability to gather telephone information on Americans. As intelligence agencies and Congress prepare to debate that balance between privacy and security, we turn to Gary Schmitt, staff director of the Senate Intelligence Committee and executive director of the president's Foreign Intelligence Advisory Board under Ronald Reagan, and Kate Martin, director of the Center for National Security Studies, a civil liberties advocacy group. How big a concession was it for the president? We're going to hear the details later this week, no doubt. Kate Martin, to decide to rein in this bulk collection program.
Well, it's a significant step. It's the president saying to his intelligence community, you haven't made the case that you need this authority, and I'm going to limit it. So it's an important recognition. You know, he did it after two separate outside reviews, which said that this particular authority wasn't needed and hadn't actually been effective in doing anything.
Gary Schmitt, a significant step or going too far?
Definitely a significant step. I mean, remember when the president made a speech about a month or so ago, he called the program important. He said that nobody had broken any laws and that it was an important tool for counterterrorism. But yet he's put together a proposal that will make the system for collecting this kind of information a little less flexible and will have a little less information to go with.
In what way?
It will be less flexible in the sense that the procedure now allows the court, I mean, the court gives a general permission, and then these numbers that they have, the NSA is able
to. Foreign Intelligence Surveillance.
Defense Court, yeah. And so the result is that NSA can check those numbers in its database. The new system will mean that the court will approve, at least if the president's proposal goes forward, the court will approve each of these requests to go forward, and it means that then they'll go to the different telephone companies and have to get that data. So it's just a much more, it's not a terrible change, but it does make the system less flexible.
Well, but what's important about the change is that at the moment, or what the NSA has been doing is collecting all of the call records on everyone. And what the president has said is, we're not going to do that anymore. Instead, the government has a phone number that it suspects is involved with a terrorist organization, and it's going to get the phone call records of the people who were in contact with that phone number and maybe one hop out. So it's significant.
But isn't it also matter, the way it's been proposed so far, who gets to hold this information and for how long, right?
Yeah, I mean, the companies are going to hold this information. It's not as though the information is not going to be retained. Now, there is a difference. The NSA retains this data for 5 years, and the telephone companies typically keep it for no longer than 18 months. So that's one of the things I was talking about when lack of depth, which is it would be harder to pursue numbers over time.
Does that hamstring the government's ability to
do this? Bit. Yes, I'm sure. Because some of these numbers, people or relationships go back for a number of years, so you want to know about those things. Is it a crippling thing? Probably not, but it's an important change.
But what's important about the change and the phone companies holding the data just means the phone companies have data on their customers, right? But what the review group that the president set up said was that the NSA having this massive database on Americans' phone calls posed risks to democratic governance, which were not necessary or justified by any national security benefit from that kind of database. And so the president said, we're not going to have that database anymore.
But ultimately, he didn't concede whether this was legal or not. Was it legal, in your opinion?
Well, the president said it was legal, and he also said that there had been no evidence of misuse of this authority. So we're fixing a flat tire that hasn't gone flat.
Well, it is true that the president believes it's legal. Its legality is under attack, under challenge.
Do you believe it's legal?
No, I don't think that they have the authority, and we're actually filing, along with lots of other groups, to say that they don't have the authority. The way the president describes it is, we can do it, but should we do it? I don't think they can do it under the law.
There's also a suspicion standard, the line of which you can cross to decide whether this is information worth getting and retaining. That's not quite clear yet where that line is. Where should it be?
Yeah, I think there are a couple things going on. One is the administration and the intelligence community couldn't show that it was critical information. They could just show that it was important information. So you have the specter of the government retaining this data, and people were suspicious, and I think that's where you're seeing the president respond, as well as the members of Congress. But that said, again, in the absence of anybody showing that something was being untowardly used, and in fact, the courts have routinely said this program was constitutional. It is kind of an odd thing that we're going through this exercise to fix something that, frankly, wasn't broken.
Why are we going through this exercise?
Well, the court that looked at it from the outside said it was unconstitutional. The FISA court said it was constitutional, and we're looking at it because when the program was brought to the light of day, the American people said to the president, why would we have the National Security Agency keep a database of every single phone call made by every single American?
So you're saying, legality aside, it just didn't smell right.
That's right. And then it wasn't that it was helpful. There was no evidence that it had been helpful in stopping any terrorist attack. There is ample historical precedent for a government misusing massive databases on its citizens. And I think that's what the president recognized.
Go ahead, you wanted to respond.
Yeah,
to that.
I think a couple things. On the misuse problem, the way the intelligence community is set up today with inspector generals and the House and the Senate oversight committees, plus justice oversight, plus the court's oversight, the idea that you could have a massive use of this data for wrongdoing, I think is just wrong. That happened in the past, but the new system under which the intelligence community operates makes it very, very unlikely you could misuse this data in that fashion.
Briefly, going forward, Congress, is there a chance this is actually going to go anywhere? Is there a movement by Congress which is going to make this move? Is there agreement?
Well, the president has said that he wants a bill from Congress, which he needs to make the changes he's talking about. According to him, there is at the moment bipartisan bills in both the Senate and in the House which would make these changes. There is maybe a majority of House members who support making these changes.
I don't think that consensus exists, and so I think it's very, unless the president gets really behind this bill, I think he's going to have a hard time passing it.
Gary Schmitt, Kate Martin, thank you both.
Thank you. Thank you.